Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How are you guys? My name is Mahmoud. I'm an Arabic language tutor. I teach Quran and Arabic to native speakers. So if you'd like to have a lesson online with me, you can email me here at ustazmahmoud184@gmail.com. Today, inshallah, we're going to take some Arabic grammar. We're going to learn some Arabic grammar. And today's lesson, inshallah, is about الجملة الفعلية. الجملة الفعلية. Or as we say in Arabic language, the verbal sentence. The verbal sentence. Okay. الجملة الفعلية. And let's see the meaning of الجملة الفعلية. What does it mean? الجملة الجملة الفعلية. الجملة الفعلية. الجملة الفعلية simply and easily. It means جملة تبدأ بفعل. Easily. Oh, what does this mean? جملة تبدأ بفعل. It means a sentence starts with a noun. That's it. A sentence starts with a noun. With a verb, I'm sorry. A sentence starts with a verb. The verbal sentence. الجملة الفعلية. جملة تبدأ بفعل. So we have in Arabic language a sentence starts with a verb, yes, okay? And this doesn't exist in English. For this, when some people, they read it, they feel that it's weird, a little bit weird for them, okay? Because in English, okay, the sentence always starts with a noun. But in Arabic, we have الجملة الفعلية, which means جملة تبدأ بفعل. A sentence starts with a verb. And let's see example. Let's see an example. مثال. مثال. Please look. كتب الطالب كتب الطالب الواجب. كتب الطالب الواجب. كتب الطالب الواجب in English means the student wrote his homework. The student or has written or wrote the homework. The student wrote the homework. كتب الطالب الواجب. Okay, and as you see here, كتب, كتب means wrote. Oh, so here كتب, the verb, it came in the beginning, started, the sentence started with a verb. كتب الطالب الواجب. الطالب means the student. الواجب is the homework. The student. الواجب means the homework. Okay, so here in this sentence, in الجملة الفعلية, the sentence started with verb. كتب الطالب الواجب. Okay, another example. So wrote here, كتب الطالب, it's in past tense. How to make it in present tense? Okay, we will say يكتب يكتب طالب الواجب. The student is writing the homework. The student is writing the homework. But here also the sentence started with this verb yaktubu, writing. يكتبوا هذه جملة فعلية جملة فعلية. Why? It started with a verb يكتب الطالب. Okay, so this we call it جملة فعلية. جملة فعلية. Why? Because it starts with فعل. فعل starts with فعل, with a verb. Okay, do you understand this? Please write. Please guys, take notes. You have to take notes. You cannot just make screenshot and just you take the lesson like this and you watch it in your mobile. No, if you are a serious student, you have your notebook and you have your pen and you have your eraser and you write, and if you have something mistake you can clean it. Okay, because this is the student, the way of the student. You must have notebook and you write your lesson. I'm sorry. Okay, now we are going to take the last part in this lesson. We're going to take arkanul jumlat al fa'liyah. Arkanul jumlat al fa'liyah, guys, means the pillars of al jumlat al fa'liyah. The pillars of the jumlat al fa'liyah. Okay, let me write it for you down. أركان 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 الجملة الفعلية. Okay, أركان means pillars. 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 الجملة الفعلية has أركان, has pillars. Okay, it has two main pillars, which they are. Let's write it down here again. أركان أركان الجملة الفعلية. It has two main pillars. It has two main pillars, which they are. One is الفعل, the verb. الفعل و الفاعل, the subject, the one who did. الفاعل. الفعل والفاعل. Two main pillars only. Any something it's extra in the sentence. So أركان الجملة الفعلية, the main two pillars in verbal sentence, they are الفعل, the verb, and الفاعل, subject. Subject, الفعل والفاعل. And let's see مثال. مثال we said means example. مثال, the previous مثال, المثال الماضي. Okay, we said كتب الطالب الواجب. كتب الطالب الواجب. كتب. Where is فعل يا شباب? Where is the verb in this sentence? كتب. Yes, very good. كتب فعل. The verb kataba. Okay, and who did the writing? Who kataba? Man kataba? الطالب جيد, very good. هذا هو فاعل. He did the writing. We call him فاعل. Subject. كتب الطالب الواجب. Oh, and what do you call الواجب? Okay, what do you call الواجب? It's written. We call him مفعول به. مفعول به. Okay, is مفعول به is main in verbal sentence? No. He's not main in the verbal sentence. Why? Because I can say كتب الطالب and that's it. كتب الطالب. But I don't need واجب. It's extra in the sentence. The sentence can give you complete meaning without الواجب. Without مفعول به. So مفعول به is extra. But فعل and فاعل, they are main. ركنان أساسان. Okay, ركنان أساسان في الجملة. الفعل والفاعل. ركنان أساسان في الجملة. الفعل والفاعل. So pillars of الجملة الفعلية, pillars of the verbal sentence are الفعل the verb and الفاعل the subject. Okay, I hope this lesson is useful for you, inshallah. If you have any question, please write in the comment and I will reply to you. Don't forget to make dua for me and for my family. Thank you, and I see you in other lessons, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.